So this happened. 1.8 million views. I thought it might be fun to go through a few stats on the video, the impact it's had, and of course cover how much money it made. But before we begin, I need to ask a favour. Please do not subscribe. I know it sounds weird, but I'll explain later. Why am I even calling this a successful video? I am sure you're thinking, 1.8 million views, that's hardly a success. Hasn't this guy heard of Mr. Beast? Well, let's have a look at how my video compares against his videos. Here's my successful video at 1.8 million views. If you look at Mr. Beast's most recent 200 videos, his average number of views is 73 million. He's also got a video in there that scored a massive 270 million plus views. We're not even in the same ballpark. So let's narrow it down a bit to my niche. Great Scott is one of the big players. He's got 1.68 million subscribers. At the time of recording, he has 391 videos. His most successful video of all time has 7 million views, but his average number of views for his last 200 videos is around 413,000. It's quite fun to do a bit of analysis on his most successful video titles. This is the top 20% titles as a word cloud, and here's his bottom 20%. Looks like his videos that are sponsored by Keysight don't do as well as his normal content. Moving even closer to home, we have the guy with the Swiss accent. He covers microcontrollers like the ESP32 and Arduino. He's got 380,000 subscribers and 422 videos. It's also interesting to look at his video titles. Here's his top 20% titles, and here's the lowest 20%. Looks like mailbag videos do less well. Andreas's top video from the last 200 got 885,000 views, and his average number of views is 100,000. Now, my channel only has 24,000 subscribers, and my average number of views is around 28,000. If you remove the 1.8 million outlier, then the average goes down to just 10,000. So hopefully you can see why I consider 1.8 million views to be a standout success. Interestingly, if we look at my bottom performing video titles, I've also got Mailbag as a low performer. What is it about this video that made it a success? The simple explanation is that the algorithm decided to push it. But that begs the question as to why it was even picked up by the algorithm. It's by no means the first video on the subject, and there are more popular channels that have covered this subject, including the Mythbusters Adam Savage's Tested channel with 5.91 million subscribers. Their video only got a measly 198,000 views. As always, I suspect it's a combination of things. The thumbnail is really good, the title has just enough clickbait to make people want to click, but not so much that it puts people off. And the first 30 seconds of the video are interesting enough to keep people engaged. But who knows with YouTube? The algorithm remains a complete mystery. I'd be interested to know what you think in the comments. How quickly was the video picked up? For the first few days, it seemed to perform pretty much as any of my other videos. There was an initial burst of views from subscribers, and then it looked like it would tail off. After 6 or 7 days, it suddenly exploded, peaking 20 days after upload at over 200,000 views in a day. It then tailed off with a brief bit of activity in January from India before settling down to just over 100 views per day. It stayed at that level of performance since then. Was there a halo effect from this video? Did people watch lots of my other videos because of it? Well, this is one of the few times that I've seen an end screen actually have a big impact. When I saw the success of the first video, I quickly followed it up with a video explaining how to make your own wireless LEDs. I added this to the end screen of the first video, and we can see that this led to 20,000 views. It's less clear if the video had any impact on my other content. We'll discuss why this is when we talk about subscribers. The video has had over 2,000 comments. There's quite an interesting effect when you start to get more people watching a video. There are a lot of very odd people out there. I've downloaded all the comments and run some analysis on them. There's definitely some interesting ones. And there seems to be a slightly weird obsession with poop, which may be related to the number of people wanting to eat them. I guess what goes in must come out. There are some great comments, and of course there are some less great ones. But the positive comments far outweigh the negative ones. The internet is actually a nice place. I'm surprised at just how nice a lot of the comments are. So what about the money? What's a successful video actually worth? Well, they are pretty lucrative. In total, the video has pulled in over £3,500 over 6 months. So is it time to retire? Well, not really. The video only brings in about 20 pence per day now. It's not a long-term revenue stream. If I wanted to make a living from YouTube, I would need to be able to repeat this on a monthly basis for the foreseeable future. Given I've got over 100 videos and this is the only successful one I've made, I'm not sure this is possible. Have I even broken even on my hobby? Well, I added up everything that I purchased since starting the YouTube channel, and the answer is maybe. If I include all the revenue from YouTube, plus sponsorship and Patreon, then I may have actually made a tiny profit. However, if you look at the amount of time I've spent creating and filming videos, then it's nowhere near break even. I could have earned a lot more consulting in that time. There's a rule of thumb that for every minute of video, there's an hour of work editing, and there's also all the time actually doing the projects. There have been some fairly big outlays. I did splash out on an oscilloscope and a signal generator. I do need to buy a proper bench power supply, upgrade the 3D printer and get a better solder station, but I'll have to wait until I have some more smash hit videos. There are some full-time YouTubers in my niche, but I'm a long way off from achieving that. So, the final question, why don't I want you to subscribe? The wireless LEDs video did amazingly well in terms of subscribers. It took my channel from just over 10,000 subs to over 20,000 in the space of a couple of months. But the problem is, a lot of those subscribers just aren't interested in my content. This means that when I publish new videos, they aren't interested in clicking on them. Unfortunately, one of the ways that YouTube works out if you've got a good video is to see what your subscribers do. If your subscribers like the video, then it will push it out to more viewers. If your subscribers don't like it, then the video will quickly disappear and die. So I've gained a lot of subscribers, but they all came for a video about wireless LEDs. I'm not sure they came from my normal content. But if you do like electronics, microcontrollers, robots, embedded programming and other fun stuff, then please do subscribe and don't forget to hit the like button as well. There is one final question. Why don't I just produce more smash hit videos? I should just repeat what I did for the wireless LEDs video. Well, I wish I could, but I just don't know really what it is about the video that made it popular. Answers in the comments, please.